meatballs are your weakness, then you are in for a mouth-watering treat. To show us how to make the perfect Italian meatballs, we're joined by chefs Hilda and Laurie. Welcome. So, Hilda, first of all, what makes these the perfect meatballs?
Well, I think you do need good ingredients, which we have. You need extra virgin olive oil, and we actually develop the flavours of each component to maximise the flavours, which I'll explain as we start to collate it.
So let's just get straight into it then. So what is the first step in all of this?
Well, here I've got three types of meat, which is beef, pork and chicken. And Vic's Meat Market gave us very, very lean meat, which is exactly what I wanted. But as you already know, it's the fat that makes your meat...
Nice and moist and tasty.
That gives it flavour and moisture.
And what do you add to it?
And so what we're going to do is, because we've removed the saturated fats, we're going to add the good unsaturated fats like extra virgin olive oil.
Oh.
And so we've actually cooked our onions in extra virgin olive oil.
Cooked first?
Yes.
I usually put them in the mic just for...
By cooking them in the olive oil, you actually allow the natural sugars to develop in the onion. And it sweetens the oil and it flavours the oil as well. We'll add that to the meatballs. And so what we've done now, we're going to add the moisture and flavour back in. But it's the olive oil and not the saturated fats, which is really important. So they're a healthy meatball.
So they're good for us.
Yes, they're a healthy meatball.
And not only... I've already had one.
I love meatballs. Absolutely love it.
I've got some grated garlic here, but I don't cook the garlic because I've grated it.
Yep.
It's quite delicate and it'll burn. And if you burn garlic, it turns bitter.
Mm. Yes.
And here I've got bacon and I've removed all visible fat and that goes in. It's chopped up very, very small. It's important to chop everything up very, very small.
Yeah.
Here I've got roasted capsicum. Now, this is why our recipes are so yummy, because we try and maximise the flavours of our ingredients, like cooking the onion before it goes into the meatball. And with the roasted capsicum, we roast that so that we can remove the outer skin, which is quite bitter and hard to digest.
Yep.
And also it sweetens the capsicum and enhances the flavour. But it also makes the capsicum quite soft.
So that goes straight in?
So that goes in. What's next?
So that actually, because it's soft...
Beautiful.
It blends in beautifully.
We've got parmesan.
You can use parmesan.
Parmigiano. Are they panko crumbs?
That's pecorino cheese, and that's bread crumbs.
Sorry, what's that one? Cheese.
Pecorino cheese. Bread crumbs. Dried oregano, basil, parsley, and
googie.
Egg. Sorry to interrupt. I hear that you're a big fan of Ronnie's. A little bird told me.
Oh.
So I thought I might like to enjoy cooking with you.
I did. I chased him up Little Collins Street when I was 16.
Oh. I just wanted to say that I always put my balls in sauce.
Oh. Yeah. It's a good idea. So do you want to mix it?
Sure, absolutely. So I'll just get my hands in there.
Is there a reason that you're... Because they're sort of diet meatballs, aren't they, in a way?
They're healthy. Italian food is well known, or it's Mediterranean diet, is well known to be a good diet to adhere to.
Yep.
And these are healthy meatballs. So we cook them in extra virgin olive oil.
Quite a lot of oil in it, though. I didn't know you had to use that much oil to cook them.
Yep. As Laurie will
explain. It'll surprise you. When we do a cooking segment, we always pour the oil back in when we're finished, when it's cooled down, back into the container. And it's exactly the same. So these meatballs will not absorb
anything. They're not going to absorb
anything. They don't need
it. Ingenious.
Yeah.
So once
is there a technique for rolling your balls?
Yes, there is actually. I'll have a go if you like.
Sure.
You can't be gentle. You've got to really get in there.
Watch out, Ronnie. That's how she rolls the balls.
Yeah.
You need to learn this technique. Come on.
So you actually
you really have to give it some welling.
Here we go. Ronnie's going to have a go too.
Absolutely.
So you have to
roll your balls.
Haven't you got to have a glove on?
Oh, no, I cut myself. So there's some water here. So you dip your fingers in water and put a little bit of water on the palm of your hand.
Okay.
And you pick up a bit of meatball.
And you don't compact the meatball. That's a secret.
Yeah, you sort of just
Seal the outside, because this is what prevents the oil from seeping in.
Now, see,
it's like being Hare Krishna food.
Now, you've got this cooked...
That's wrong.
Is it? Why is it?
Well, see how mine's nice and smooth?
Yeah.
Yours is not smooth. See, it's got cracks
in it. So you need to pipe it in.
So that's, no, that is important so that you don't have a bit of onion sticking out or a bit of garlic or anything.
Because what happens is if you don't get a smooth surface area, the oil seeps in and gives you a soggy meatball or an oily bit.
Soggy balls. We don't want soggy balls.
And we've got a wonderful book. It's Italian. And you've got a recipe here that it's called Nonna's Ricotta Cake.
Yes.
And it's her recipe.
Oh, yeah, it's actually my mother-in-law made that recipe up. It wasn't handed down to her. She decided to put a little bit of this, a little bit of that in. And it's absolutely beautiful. It's an amazing cake.
You'll never get another ricotta cake like that.
Yeah.
Well, the pictures are good, the photos are good because they lead you into what you want to have for dinner. And
Exactly.
Big photos.
Well, yeah. thank you both so much for being here, Hilda and Laurie. And you can stay.
Do you want to try the new sauce?
And a huge thank you as well to Vic's Meat Market, which is located in the Sydney Fish Market, for supplying all the meat in today's segment. Thank you very much.